We're going through Transformers. One, two, three, four.
Time, timer flash 7 times. BTU system. You ain't testing, you're guessing.
What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. It's me, Mikey Pipes. Today is Thursday, October 19th, 2023, and we are heading to a service call in Cambria Heights, Queens, which is just over, or just past the Cross Island Expressway, in the borough of Queens, in the great city of New York. Thank you so much for tuning in. In case you guys have not tuned in before, my name is Mike Dyack. I'm a licensed master plumber in certain jurisdictions of the state of New York, the entire state of South Carolina, and real soon, we're opening up an office in Florida. So if we are near you, where you live, I'll be more than happy to give you a call to help you out, give you a house call. You can reach me at mike@mikeypipes.com. All right, we're going to a new client. Apparently, he saw me on YouTube, and he only wants me. He got a little, a little demanding on the phone, and I was going to not go out to him today, but apparently he's closing on his house tomorrow, and he's got a problem with the thermostat. So I don't think it's the thermostat. It's probably going to be something else. That's the way it usually is, but let's head over. We've got one more block to go. And let's see what's going on. Hopefully, I'll be able to get some great content for you guys. Smash that thumbs up button and subscribe if you haven't done so already. Let's go.
So, the spoiler was working. They took the thermostat.
Who's they?
The guy who's working in the house. And it doesn't fire, but I don't think it's that. It's probably something to do with the boiler.
Where's the thermostat? Nice kitchen.
You see the wires for the thermostat, right? So I just, the white and the black, these are not connected to anything downstairs. This is connected.
Okay.
Is there a clog? Why isn't the water coming out?
All right, Burnham SIN5, 140,000 BTU gas-fired boiler from June 2014. Someone's been tinkering with it. Have you been tinkering with this thing?
I just took the cover off.
Why?
A few minutes ago.
Why?
Because I was like, I don't know, but does it do anything?
What were you going to do inside of it to tell me?
I don't know, and then I didn't know what to do, so I left it alone.
But what were you going to do inside? You had an intention.
I have no clue.
Okay. Pressure gauge reading around 2.5-3 PSI. And our sight glass, I gotta tell you, this sight glass, if she looks like a pig and she squeals like a pig, she is a pig, right? This sight glass is full of water. You know what that means? That means the boiler. Oh, drain. Drained complete.
Easy fix, and you don't charge me anything.
Oh yeah, so we got a full flooded boiler. Let's open the drain, which it is open. So we have a clog drain. No bueno. All right, he knows he needs a new drain, but let's see if we could use water pressure and flush out the boiler drain. Okay. I'm quite confident she is now clear. So let's close that back off. Oh, wrong way. The ratcheting 11 and 1. That's closed. Let's take this out. And abracadabra. Abracadabra. A la peanut butter sandwiches. All right. The question now is, while these guys scan in that QR code, by the way, you should scan in this QR code, by the way, make a donation to the Mikey Pipes Philanthropy charitable organization. There you go. And it'll bring you to PayPal. Every dollar helps. There you go. The question now is, let's have a little contest. How many buckets, and we're not going to use that bucket, but
counting one of those, how many of these buckets are we going to need to bring the water level halfway in the sight glass?
Four.
Your bet is four. Okay? Ladies and gentlemen, the closest without going over is going to win a free sticker package. Sticker package. Yeah, I have like seven stickers like that. Yeah. You see? And it brought you to the page.
Yes, it did.
See? Okay, you think four. I'm going to bet we're probably going to be around six. Ah, let's put that off to the side. That's one. Well, okay. All right, so you know what? We'll give you four and a half. All right, this is bucket number two. Oh, gotta keep our boots dry. How would it flood? You see this valve right here? Someone decided to leave that open. All right, so this is bucket number three.
Oh, that one was open?
No, I said someone decided to leave it open. There's number three. See, that's the boiler feed valve. After the backflow preventer, this is the boiler feed valve before it. So if I ever need to change this, I can close that and voila. But someone overfilled this boiler because they were blind. Maybe like Ray Charles or Helen Keller. No disrespect to Ray Charles or Helen Keller, but if you if you're blind, you know you need Braille, right? So this is bucket. We're filling up bucket number four. There is no advantage that I had, right? The only thing that I knew, right, is that by looking at the sight glass, I knew the boiler was full of water. And by popping open the relief valve on that far corner there and water came out of there, that means water is at a minimum here, right? And I know that if I go into the manual for this IN5, let's look at the manual. All right, so here is the dimensional data. We have an IN5, which is the third one down, and we have steam. No, yeah, third one down. Steam, water volume of gallons. Third one down is 7.9 gallons. So under normal operating conditions, this boiler holds 7.9 gallons of water. So.
Normally,
right? So, but to your advantage, you lost though. You lost. There's the water level of the sight glass. And we're almost filled with number four. So maybe you won. Yeah, I think we're four and a half because we're gonna dump this. We're gonna close this, right? You're gonna dump this bucket, and you will be right at that halfway point. But guess what? We're just getting started.
Am I getting paid for?
Yeah, you're paying for this. It's okay. But we're just getting started because that won't really prevent the boiler from firing. Maybe it would. Maybe there's that much pressure on the pressure troll and the pigtail. Maybe, just maybe, but we're going to find out. All right, I removed one of the lines going to our pressure troll, and we're going to test for continuity. Oh, do you know what? The screws are painted blue, so maybe that's why we didn't catch anything before. No, you see? We have no continuity. See? I had to rig it with the Wago. It broke off. So we have continuity there, but between these two, we have no continuity, right? So this pressure troll will prevent boiler operation. Let's figure out why it's preventing boiler operation. Let's remove the other screw, the other terminal. Let's pull the wiring out and pull the pressure troll off and take a look at the pigtail. Let's see what happens. Now the pressure troll is removed from the pigtail. Let's see if there's continuity on it. And there isn't. Our pressure troll is dead. And just for shits and giggles, let's put it upright. And then we'll touch those two terminals. Maybe. No. Now it's good. All right. Here is our new straight brass alloy pigtail. Put that on there. Okay, right there is good. All right, and let's reinstall the pressure troll.
All right, new pigtail is in. Pressure troll is wired. Our pressure dropped down to normal, which is zero, because there is no pressure. Let's turn on the switch. Let's touch those two wires together, and we'll see what happens. Or can we do it here?
No, we can't do it here.
Yeah, but give it a minute, though, because the low water cutoff is still booting up. It runs off Windows, you know, not Android, so it takes a little while. No, you're good now. You could do it. There's our vent damper. And as long as our rollout spill switch there is closed, our rollout switch is closed, our low water cutoff is good, our pressure troll is good, our automatic vent damper. Oh. No bueno. Something is wrong. I would disconnect those two wires fast.
Disconnect
them? Yep. Something's not right. Something's not right. Something is not right. Something is not right. Okay. So, let's go. You disconnected them? Transformer number three. Okay, so that one didn't blow up. We're going through transformers. One, two, three, four. Crazy. All right, following the schematic, all the yellows, as well as the 24 volts from transform, which is the green wire together, our blues with thermostat, brown from thermostat relay goes to thermostat, the oranges go together, the pinks go together, the grays go together, the reds go together. So if we touch those two wires together, hopefully it doesn't blow up. Let's see what happens. Look at that. Thermostat clicked on. Voila, that's why I get paid the big bucks.
That's what you call ignition, ladies and gentlemen. It's coming.
There it is, baby. Oh yeah. I am the light. Nice, good blue flame. Very nice. All right. So I was originally sent here because I think you called around 11 o'clock today, right? And I was originally sent here because you had a steam boiler with thermostat issues and you're closing the house tomorrow. Does that sum it up about right?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. All right. So upon arrival, we found the boiler was flooded and removed 4.5 buckets of excess water, right? The pigtail was clogged. So I replaced that. The boiler wouldn't fire. This is when it gets good. Found low voltage control circuits wired wrong, disconnected wires, and multiple blown transformers. So far, so good, right? Good. We installed a new transformer at the junction box in the ceiling. We moved the switch to the ceiling to kill the line voltage instead of the low voltage. We rewired all the controls, recycled system, and it's testing okay. Right, so you have your trip charge, you have the labor, you have your pigtail, and you have your transformer. So let's play a game, high or low.
Pigtail is not copper. So maybe
it's brass. Well, it's brass alloy.
Brass. No one cares about brass.
The but also keep in mind, like I'm not Amazon. I know, I'm not Amazon. That transformer is not like you're buying it on Amazon for like $75.
$115 for trip charge.
And you have an hour and a half of labor.
Hour and a half of labor. And the 115 gets taken off.
No, it gets, it's part of it, yeah.
All right.
So what do you think?
And then we have rewiring, which is such a simple thing.
Yeah. And by the way, the reason why I immediately said this was wrong is because you have your steam header pipe coming up out of the top, right? Which is the height is okay. And then we turn, we elbow. The problem is this T. Okay. This T should have been here, pointing up, and we can carry across with our equalizer for equal pressure. Now, you had asked, what's the purpose of a pigtail?
Yes.
Right? The purpose of the pigtail is to spare the pressure troll that latent heat that it can get damaged by the steam that's created by the boiler. So normally, there's some water in here, right? And as, you know, low pressure, which is literally, you're talking about a PSI or 2 PSI of pressure at most, right? As long as the pressure troll is set right, you know, and the pigtail is not clogged,
our pigtail is clogged, the boil will run until the thermostat turns off. You know, the relief valve will pop at 15 PSI. That happens. You see that because people neglect their boilers. So the purpose of the pigtail is to keep the latent heat that the boiler creates off the pressure troll. You only want the pressure troll to sense pressure.
Got it.
Okay?
So that loop helps it.
Yes, the loop acts as a trap, right? Because water will form in there, right? And it also keeps that steam off of it. That it's called latent heat, but that's what it's, the dead men called it. So on older boilers, you know, black pipe was frequently used. On the newer version of this, now it's shipped in brass because it's less likely to clog. Believe it or not, boiler manufacturers don't want you to like spend money on replacing things that aren't necessary as long as, you know, but we learn over time. So this is a straight pigtail, we replaced that, and that was the first thing we tested that, you know, didn't work, you know, because we had no continuity with the boiler off there. Remember with the dead, the strip wire? So you got a new pigtail, pressure pull worked, but then we didn't have firing when we jumped out thermostat R and W. Up there. That's because everything in there was wired wrong. Sucks. But listen, thank God they didn't destroy anything, because if that was dead or the vent damper was dead, you know, the bill would be a lot higher than it is right now.
What is it now?
Take a guess.
Say 115, 215.
He's going to be wrong.
What do you think, guys? Is he going to be wrong or is he going to be right? Or is he hot, under or over? I guarantee you're going to be under.
I think it should be $600, but, you know.
You're close. You're close. You're under.
How under?
Not by much.
There you go.
Is it there? Not terrible.
No, like,
not terrible.
No.
Not terrible. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's summarize this service call. Quality doesn't cost, it pays. And the more experience you have, the more valuable you become. The plumbing and HVAC world, you know, being a blue collar worker is a position that can never be outsourced to a call center in like Korea or India, you know, or overseas, right? The knowledge is power. So my only advice, if you're just getting into the field, is to make it a mission to learn something new every day. Learn something new today that you didn't know yesterday, right? Because the next time you open up that box, the side panel on a Burnham Independence boiler, and you see, oh, listen, the brown wire's not going anywhere. Well, that's kind of odd. Well, you'll know right away that something is wrong. You know what? If they would have called another company, they could have putzed around with that machine for hours upon hours upon hours. Trust me, I've been there, done that. I've seen that. Even my own guys been there, done that. I've seen that. You know? One thing that pops into my head right now is that my guy Mike, the other Mike, went on a service call a few years ago. Customer has no heat. Spent all day there replacing parts, replacing the damper, low water cup, becoming a parts changer. And guess what was wrong? The T87F thermostat on the wall. Been there, done that, but you gotta learn something new every day, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for tuning in. Smash that thumbs up button. If you haven't done so already, please subscribe. Be well, God bless, stay safe.